Hey people, it's me, Ginny Metheral. Today's video is all about fairy tea. Now for those of you that don't know me, I'm a fourth generation witch who practices traditional magic, or the old ways, and I've been doing it all my life, ever since I was small, without realising it, being taught by my mother, by my family, by my coven. The last video that I did was all about meeting the fae. I'll put the video up here for you if you haven't seen it, so you can catch up if you'd like. However, it occurred to me when I was walking outside that the beautiful spring flowers are covering the bank against my drive at the moment, and aren't they stunning? It's primroses, oxlips and cowslips mainly, with a couple of tulips and daffodils thrown in. And it occurred to me when I was looking at this wondrous spring array that we could make a fairy tea, because of course cowslips, oxlips and primroses all contain a high degree of lutein. Lutein is a vitamin, a bit like beta carotene, but it's a very country traditional way of meeting with the fae. Cowslip wine, anyone? I don't have time to show you how to brew cowslip wine, and I'm not sure I can because I'm not a great brewer. I do occasionally brew wildflower champagnes and wines, and they are absolutely delicious if they haven't blown up first. So I'm not going to show you that, I'm just going to show you the most easy tea. The tea itself is incredibly magical. The lutein in it makes your eyes open wide to the fae world. Firstly, you must pick your flowers. I'm going to use the cowslips and primroses. Primroses are single stalked, as you can see here, and cowslips have the several flower heads on the same stalk. There is much folklore concerning the beautiful primrose. It is said to attract the fae, to repel the fae, and to also bring great joy and love. It is a flower of love, but mostly it is the flower for communing with the fae. Of course, you might not have primroses and cowslips in the part of the world where you live, and I cannot really give you anything to substitute. You can buy dried primrose flowers and those will work, so you could try that. Let me know if you're going to do this in the comments below and, you know, what you thought of the tea. One last word of warning is that primroses were on the endangered list of wildflowers, but actually they're not. I think they've come off now. However, cowslips have gone straight onto it. So I would say don't go out and pick them willy-nilly. These are flowers to be enjoyed and loved, and if you've got them growing in your garden, then that's probably the best thing, like me.
Making the tea is of course extremely easy. Rinse off your flowers to avoid any bugs, and then I want you to take each of the flowers and separate the petals from the sepals, and this is the bit that's going to make your tea. These cowslips I'm going to put straight into the cup, and then pulling off the rest of the flower petals, I will put those into steep in my teapot. These flowers also have a mildly narcotic effect, so if you suffer from insomnia, this is a wonderful thing to drink at night. Pour on boiling water and let the flowers sit for 5 to 10 minutes. Your tea is now ready to drink. And as you can see, it's the most beautiful yellow colour, which is all the lutein fairy magic. This tea will now give you some ability in helping you see the fae.
I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to check out my Patreon page. I'll put the link here, www.patreon.com/JinnyMetheral. We had to postpone the April Coven meeting until next week due to various factors, so there is still time to join. Do come along and have a look. do give me a like and a subscribe. And as always, I'll see you in my next video.